motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Blow a wisdom on the mic with Sean Anthony.
Get motivated.
Get it right with Sean Anthony.
Get motivated. Get motivated.
That's right, get motivated, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Flow of Wisdom Radio, Hour 2. Thank you so much for tuning in live here on the Genesis Communications Network. The toll-free number is 877-300-7645. And the website is flowofwisdom.com. That way you can get in contact with me on my social media, connect you to Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, et cetera, et cetera. And of course, the YouTube channel, just type in Flow of Wisdom and it will come up. And subscribe to the YouTube channel. And, cause these shows will go up on there. And that's how you can really share Flow of Wisdom as well. In addition to downloading the podcast for yourself on gcnlive.com. And just do a search for Sean Anthony Flow of Wisdom and you'll get it, man. So, there you go. Look, hour two, more jam-packed information. And I must say, this series has been one that has been very interesting because number one, science has always interested me throughout my life. Ever since I was a young kid, I always loved science and, I just enjoy learning more about it. So this story is really fascinating to me because, I mean, you talk about things, you know, that's why I was pointing out in the last article that I was reading, sharing with you guys in the, which one was it? The Inquisitor? Yeah. And how they were pointing out what quote unquote conspiracy theorists are saying, but yet they'll go on further in an article citing some of today's physicists. Such as Stephen Hawking and Neil deGrasse Tyson and their perspectives on the same things, the same subjects. But yet when they point these people out, they don't call them conspiracy theorists. And then I share with you an article in NASA talking about that they send a spacecraft to hunt down hidden portals, which is in the Earth's magnetic field. And the key word to me is hidden, because that lets me know that there are portals that are not hidden. But here's some information that I want to share with you. For those that don't know, you don't remember, my interviews with Cisco Wheeler. Cisco Wheeler, guys, she was a former member in the occult. She underwent MK Ultra and just had a traumatic life. I probably had more personal conversations with Cisco Wheeler than I've had her on the show. And I've had her on the show at least three or four times. And you know, sometimes she'll just be so just, you could just tell when someone has been through a traumatic life. Her father was a full-blown Satanist, and she was raised in the occult. She was a handler for what some of people call the Illuminati, and she was just privy to all of this information. And over the years, she ended up getting she turned her life around, and she, with the help of some people, through therapy and things of that nature, to get reversed or whatever. I have to bring her back on to let her explain it a little bit more thoroughly. But I remember having her on before, and we had a really interesting conversation. It's on YouTube too. You could check that out. She talked about vortexes and ley lines and stuff like that. But nonetheless, she sent me some information, and I want to read it to you because I think it all goes in line with the subject matter, CERN portals and ley lines. This is going to be tying into more of the ley lines and portal side of things. I know the first couple of weeks we've really been focusing on CERN. Then we focus a little bit more on the portals and stuff like that. So we kind of tie that in today. We're going to dive into the ley lines aspect of it. And I'm going to share some of this information that she sent me. And it's a lot. So I'm not going to get through all of it throughout the show, because I do want to keep the show open. I want to keep the show interactive. If you guys have comments, questions, or you want to add something to the conversation, what have you, feel free to do so. 877-300-7645. And so I'll go ahead and begin. This was information that Cisco Wheeler sent to me. She says, Sean, Satanists believe that the earth is overlaid with grid lines, along with which powerful supernatural occult power may flow, exactly as electricity flows through a circuit. This Luciferian power thus is envisioned to flow through this circuit grid, crisscrossing as it continually flows within the planetary grid. Following with this Luciferian power are numerous vortexes. She then breaks down the definition of vortex, and it says flow involving rotation about an axis, any activity regarded as drawing into its center and engulfing all that surrounds it. All right, side note, guys, think of it like a whirlpool in a pool, or a tub. When you let the ring out of the tub and the water starts to go down the drain and starts to circle, I'm trying to give you a visualization. That's what a vortex would look like, okay? Certain important vortexes are thought to act as a pillar supporting the golden age or new age that is coming. Baphomet, goat's heads of Mendez. Occultists believe that one very powerful vortex is, check this out, is located in the capital of the United States in Washington, D.C. Satanists believe that once a satanic symbol is drawn on the ground, it begins to reverberate with occult power 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. In rituals, the witch will almost always draw a powerful symbol on the ground from which she will conduct the ceremony. In the case of Washington, D.C., Masonic planners originally conceived that the street designs of the Capitol would be laid out in the most powerful satanic symbols possible, so that the entire federal government complex would reverberate with satanic power every day of the year. This continuous flow of power directly from Lucifer himself would gradually and inevitably move this country in the direction of the occult, and would give its leaders the most incredible power as they deal with the leaders of other nations. Now, let me take a quick little pause here for a moment, because one of the reasons why I want to kind of put a pause on this series on CERN portals and ley lines, because there's some other subjects that I want to cover. And the reason why I'm bringing this up right now at this particular point, after that, what I just shared with you, most people in America would believe that the forefathers were so-called Christians or of the Christian faith. When you ask many of the Americans, most people, even I, was under the impression that most of the founding fathers of the United States, well, the quote-unquote founding fathers, after they didn't deal what they did with the Native Americans, the original people, the indigenous people of this land, the founding fathers of what the United States, we'll say that, and not the land, most people would think that they're Christians. But lo and behold, when you start to do a little, I can't even say a little, you got to do a lot of digging and quite a bit of research and reading and diving in some information, you find that a lot of them were not. Do you guys know who Albert Pike is? Albert Pike is one of the the forefathers of Freemasonry. He wrote a book entitled Morals and Dogma, and I'm going off the top of my head, guys. He wrote a book on morals and dogma, and his book, he's first, before I say that, like, he's the man when it comes like the Freemasonry. Like, he's the guy. Like, you that's the guy. Full blown Luciferian. Like, just Lucifer is his god. Like, there's no doubt about Albert Pike. Who does he worship? Who is his god? Lucifer. You can look it up, find out. You will come to the conclusion Lucifer is his god. Okay? Did you not know they have a statue of Albert Pike in Washington, D.C.? Did you guys know that? Full-blown Luciferian. Full-blown satanic cult, occult worship, all of that stuff. So when you listen to this information that I'm sharing with you today, does it all surprise you? Remember when a caller called in a show a couple of weeks ago, and I was telling him, I was like, you know, people tell you, you know, not to be so religious, and, you know, I'm not to be religious or anything, and I even felt faulted saying that. And at the same time, these people that are into this occult and this ritual and this Luciferianism and satanic worship, oh, they are the most religious folks that I keep running into. And I keep reading about, they are religious. They are very serious about their occult magic and all of that. I'll finish this up right after this break. It's Flow of Wisdom Radio. All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony, live here on the Genesis Communications Network. The number is 877-300-7645. Excuse me. If you're just tuning in, I was sharing some information that was sent to me from Cisco Wheeler. Cisco Wheeler is an author of a book called Beheld a White Horse. And not to confuse it with Bill William Cooper's book, Behold a Pale Horse. Cisco was she was in the occult. She was under the influence of MK Ultra. She was a handler for the occult and for the Illuminati, and she wrote some books on it, and she wrote a lot of information on it. In fact, she's been on the show several times, just exposing and sharing whatever she can now. But she sent me some information pertaining to the ley lines and some grids, some that's overlaid, you know, in the earth's on the earth's surface, has been overlaid with grid lines, along with powerful supernatural occult power. And I'm just kind of sharing with that with you guys the information that she sent to me. All right. In rituals, the witch will almost always draw a powerful symbol on the ground. I read that part. She goes on to tell me, if you look at a map in which you can see that the map of Washington, D.C., you can see that the bottom portion of the goat's head of Mendez pentagram encompasses the White House. Since this portion of the goat head is thought of as containing the brain or the mind of Satan, mind you, we're looking at the map of Washington, D.C., okay? Since this portion of the goat head is thought of as containing the brain, the mind of Satan, then you can safely say that the power of Satan continuously flows through the White House. The President of the United States, if he is a practicing occultist, would be infused with incredible occult power as he directed the affairs of state and when he met with foreign leaders. Now let us consider that as our nation was continuously dedicated to Satan through careful orientation to the dog star, Sirius, so our buildings and government mall were dedicated to and established according to the power of the serpents of wisdom. What you say are the serpents of wisdom. As we take you through a discussion of really deep Satanism, we are indebted to former black magic Satanist Cisco Wheeler, who is now born again. And as I said, she's authored several books. One of them was particularly on the Illuminati mind control. Now, this information, guys, some of you that have seen certain videos on the internet, they kind of point it out. They show the diagram of the goat, the goat's head, the goat of Mendez, the Baphomet, if you will, outline the way that the city is strategically structured. The streets. You talk about the Washington Monument and it being like, well, it's the obelisk, but it being like a phallus symbol. Other information she sent. Let's see. The pillar of the United States of America was founded by the Serpents of Wisdom, who assigned the number 13 to the new nation. The phoenix bird from the earliest history. The phoenix bird was the symbol of the United States. The phoenix also has the number, the assigned number 13. Thus, it was that the United States was formed once she had 13 colonies. The number 13 assigned to the United States is spoken by the New Age author Bill Cooper in his book, Behold a Pale Horse. Cooper marvels at many instances of 13 that occur in the symbolism of the United States. Cooper notes the following instances of 13 in our great seal, shown in two parts of the back of the $1 bill, the eagle, the unfinished pyramid. What Cooper says in the Great Seal of the United States, we see that the ancient symbol of the Brotherhood of the Snake, which, as you already know, is the all-seeing eye in the pyramid representing Lucifer in the form of wisdom. And these are words from William Cooper. But also, the all-seeing eye atop the unfinished pyramid represents the Brotherhood of the Snake, which we also know as the Illuminati. I'll finish this up, guys. When we come back, we'll take a quick break here on Flow of Wisdom Radio. We're going to talk about dimensions next. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am Sean Anthony. And CERN portals and ley lines. We're going into some heavy, heavy stuff here. Just pointing out things of how the city of Washington, D.C. was created and the ideology, if you will, behind it is none less than occult magic, occult practice. The capital of the United States, as Cisco Wheeler sent me some information, saying that Washington, D.C. was built exactly according to these energy-conducive shapes. Within the city, you see pyramids, triangles galore, along with spheres, and the largest and most famous obelisk in the world, the Washington Monument, and the domes of on many of the buildings. Masonic planners fully intended to build a city that would reestablish lines of communication. Quote, this is a quote. Reestablish lines of communication with the third and fourth dimensional serpents. In the mind of the occultist, Washington, D.C. literally was an open channel of satanic power emanating from the vortex of the earth on which she was built and extending into the third and fourth dimensions, calling forth certain serpent power upon the capital city. Quoting, when a structure is in place, according to rule, the serpent slash dragon that is living within each building takes on the form of a serpentine spiral of energy. An occult priest, a master, can physically, quote, see the spiraling etheric body. The serpent has the ability to place special energy in these type structures as these megalithic forms become the physical home of the etheric serpent and its spiraling body. Man, this is really interesting. She tells me that the serpent will continually move left to right, up and down, inside and out of the structure. Can you imagine that? Visualize that spiritually? This makes the spirit more conductive. Phi, or the golden proportion, whatever that means. The numeric constant which determines the serpent spiral is incorporated into the dimensions of these structures. So the megaliths will fully harmonize with the movement of the life force. You know, it's interesting. You know, people, some people just don't, people think, how can I say this? Father, help me. You know, sometimes people just don't pay attention to the things that are around you, symbolisms and power and symbols. People, if there was no power in symbols, then there would not be any. If they didn't think, like, they wouldn't be so symbolic messages. They're in our commercials, they're in advertising, they're on billboards. Like, these people truly believe that there is power in symbols. Like, I'm telling you, but I'm sharing with you today what she, the occult teaches them. It was interesting. Me and my family were out at a particular mall in the Richmond area, and outside the malls, you know, it's one of the nicest malls here in the area. And, some of the structure, structure as we were leaving out of the wall, my wife pointed out something to me. She's like, look at that. Does that not look like a phallus to you? And it was like these stone, small pillars. They only came up to you like maybe waist high. But she pointed out the tip of it looked like a phallus. Now, for those that don't know what the phallus, what do you mean phallus, Sean? You know, because some people just don't know. That's cool. A penis. Sexual organ. These are sexual organs. Like, it looks like, you think about an obelisk, that's a phallus symbol. These people are very, very into to weird things, and it's just, when you start reading that stuff, and, you know, and trust me, if you it ain't for you to do, then don't do it, you know. But it's right there. It's all around. If you guys have ever come to Washington, D.C., it's, you know, those buildings, it's a sight to see. And the structures of it, it's amazing. The architect, the intricate detail in a lot of the buildings, not only in Washington, D.C., but I'm sure you can find it. Go to the capital of your state, wherever you live at. Go to the capital. I'm certain. Just take some pictures and send it to me on flowofwisdom.com. I'm certain you will see occult symbolisms in a lot of the capitals in the cities in the United States. You'll see it. So, where were we? As the serpent life forces spirals down one branch of the conductive structure, its essence is transferred into a network of dragon lines, which will go off in all four directions following structured pattern lines. This energy must be harnessed as its dispersing life force must not be allowed to dissipate. This is the deepest reason the colonizing serpents or demons strategically place churches, temples, and buildings along Earth's etheric highway grid. Other forms that can be used to house this serpentine spiral energy are triangles, six-pointed stars, spirals, crosses, phallic symbols, Like obelisks and stones collectively, these structures support self-sufficient dragon communities, end quote. Essentially, ladies and gentlemen, let me kind of try to paraphrase what Cisco is saying here. Just think about from this point on, you're now accountable for what you know. From this point on, just think about where certain buildings are located in your city. Or think about where they are, you know, in our country. But I say in your city because that's where you can go immediately. You can look at your downtown. Don't think for one moment that certain buildings, structures, what do you call them? Monuments. Oh, thank you. Monuments. They aren't strategically placed in specific positions. Don't ever doubt that. Don't think it's by an accident that this particular structure is pointing east, or this particular structure is pointing in that direction, you know, or this structure is facing this building here. Like, trust and believe this stuff is strategically done. She even talks about, she says, you can now get the idea of why the government building to house our military might was built in the form of a pentagon. That powerful five-pointed symbol of Satan's power, the pentagon was built to support self-sufficient dragon/serpent communities. Think about it, guys. The obelisk is considered one of the most important part of this entire pattern and structure. The Washington Monument is the most important as a link between Earth and the upper dimensions. As Cisco explains, the obelisk is a very important energy conductive maker. An obelisk is taught to Masons as a symbol of the phallus. But the deepest level meaning is that it is really a frozen snake. Obelisks support the serpent life force as it spirals between heaven and earth. The shape of the obelisk was inspired by huge generator crystals. Atlantean firestone, the life force accumulators and amplifiers, end quote. So you got to understand why it was important for that Washington Monument to be erected in the government center. Washington, D.C. was created to be the first such dragon or serpent city. And then others started to follow. And, you know, speaking of Washington, D.C., I was listening to some kind of news report. And I just, you know, it just really dawned on me. A lot of people think Washington, most people, I can't say. There are certain people here in the United States, due to our public education here in the United States, they think Washington, D.C. is a state. It's not. Washington, D.C. is not a state. New Jersey is a state. Ohio is a state. Michigan is a state. Virginia is a state. Washington, D.C. is not a state. The same with London and the Vatican, the Vatican City. Those three, Washington, D.C., London, and the Vatican, they are all one. The Vatican is part of the church. London is the financial realm. Washington, D.C., the military. Three heads, guys. They all are intertwined with one another. So, I don't know about you guys, but for me, I find this very interesting. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. 877-300-7645. If I have time, I'll share with you a little bit of some information about a physicist at CERN that's gone missing. I'll start it off right there. It says, I'm a physicist at CERN. We've done something we shouldn't have. I'll try to pick it up when we come back from this break, y'all. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am Sean Anthony. My website is flowofwisdom.com. And please, any questions, comments, concerns, anything, hit me up there, flowofwisdom.com. There is a contact page, and you can get at me that way. Robert X sent me this, and I've been trying to share this for the past couple of weeks, but, you know, the information flows, and callers call in, and the information gets pushed back. So I'm going to try to share with you as much of this as I possibly can. This was from a physicist at CERN, and he says, we've done something wrong. He said, please advise of the following. Number one, I am breaking international laws regarding privacy and secrecy by publishing this information. Two, I am not going to disclose my location since I know that any attempt to prove what I have seen or what I've been a part of will result in my immediate and thorough extermination. He goes on to write, my name is Dr. Edward Mantle, and I was and technically still am a physicist at CERN, located in Geneva, Switzerland. I specialize in particle and subatomic research focusing on quark interactions. In other words, I study very, very small particles and how they interact with one another at very high speeds. Until Thursday, January 15th, 2014, I was a normal scientist living and working on the CERN campus. Most of the scientists who are involved in the branch of research that I am live on campus at the facility in Geneva and venture out only on for social activities and the occasional visit home. Most of you have heard of CERN, will have heard of the Large Hadron Collider, the largest scientific instrument, which exceeds 20 miles in diameter, 20 miles, Public has been told that this was constructed at a cost of tens of billions of euros for the purpose of studying the birth of the universe and the collisions that take place within the collider allow us a quick glimpse at certain phenomenon that can only be witnessed when particles hit one another at incredible high rates. This is not what the machine was designed for, nor is it what the machine has been used for since its inception. CERN's main purpose for building the collider was to open a doorway. Allow me to explain. The doorway idea came into fruition in the 1960s after years and years of attempting to hide UFO phenomenon, including large scale and very public interactions such as the Roswell incident and the battle for Los Angeles incident. Well before that, the governments of the United States, Great Britain, and France decided to throw their weight behind the understanding of what precisely these objects were. The ideas flew far and wide. Were UFOs from another planet? Were they from another time? Or were they simply mass hysteria and mass delusion fueled by the overactive imagination of a public who were scared of communists and their technology? No, there were none of these. Our universe is but one page in a large book. Think of a closed book sitting on a table. You see the page stacked on top of another, bound by a spine, sandwiched between two covers. Our universe is but one page in a vast of all-encompassing book. Let me fast forward a little bit. Within a few short years of mathematical research and fleets of scientists working under the threat of extermination, should they share their research, the book idea was finally cemented. Though many disagreed, the mathematics were there to support the book idea, and the mathematics showed us that it was impossible for one page to interact with another. That was until the 1980s. During the 1980s, billions of dollars of research was funneled into the idea that if we used enough energy, if we used enough force concentrated into a small area the size of a pinprick, we could theoretically tear our page and get a glimpse of the next page to ours. We could open a door from their universe to ours. When the family, which is the code name for the group of scientists that functioned as the head of each of their departments at CERN, They were shown the initial presentation in March of 1981. Many of them expressed grave concern about the ramifications of an opening of such a doorway, but in the beautiful name of science, the family decided to share these ideas with governments who constantly funded their research. There was a meeting that was held in Luxembourg. The heads of state of the newly forming European Union, along with the United States and China, were shown plans for the construction of the colossal machine that was to enable the opening of a doorway, which we call CERN, the Hadron Collider. Guys, that's it for this week. We'll pick it up again next week. I promise. We'll do another part on CERN portals and ley lines. I hope you all live life, get good godly wisdom, and let it flow. I'm Sean Anthony. Peace.